Ashley, you spoke with three Utahns who had to escape the flames. Their focus is now on Hawaii locals who have lost everything.
Dini, those women from Ogden, Farmington, and South Jordan work right on Front Street in Lahaina, one of them losing their apartment and all of their belongings. But as you said, they are not focusing on that. Those items can be replaced. They are concerned about the local Maui families who've lost everything, including family members.
It's heartbreaking seeing how many people's homes and like everyone's livelihood on like that side of the island is just gone.
Utahns Abby, Alexa, and Morgan still can't believe the devastation they're witnessing. The place they've grown to love, now leveled by wildfires. They thankfully escaped on Tuesday, capturing these videos on their way out of Lahaina.
It was just terrifying. Yeah, and it was bumper to bumper. Like there was just nothing you could do.
Yeah, we weren't moving. We're just going to be stuck
there. And people were panicking, like running out of their car,
going to the beach,
driving their car on the sidewalk.
Their office along historic Front Street, one of nearly 270 structures destroyed in the quick-moving flames.
It just went completely black. Like, it was 4 in the afternoon, and it looked like midnight.
Alexa's apartment up the street also burned down, but their focus is now on the Maui locals who've lost everything.
They've lost their businesses, they've lost their homes, they've lost family members. Like, they have nothing left.
The group volunteering at local shelters to help feed those in need.
We would get them water and get them food, give them prepackaged meals for every single member of the family. And
they want Utahns to understand the severity of the situation and hope by sharing their experience, others will consider donating to the people of Maui.
Help them rebuild their lives and make sure that they get to keep their land and keep what belongs to them.
The group says the most heartbreaking encounters are with locals looking for family members they have yet to hear from. Now, those strong winds knocking down power lines and cutting off communication, another reason why those evacuations weren't clearly communicated. Back to you.
Boy, Ashley, that video is just devastating.
It is.
Thank you.